Good morning and welcome to this Tuesday morning's Real Estate Bulletin. The main points are, in the largest private equity buyout so far in India's real estate sector, Xander Group has agreed to acquire 100% interest in Shriram's Gateway SEZ in Chennai for $190 million or about ₹1,220 crores, with further commitment of $160 million to expand commercial component of the integrated township. The deal involved 1.7 million square feet of occupied and operational special economic zone and a partnership with Shriram Properties to deliver the under construction 1.9 million square feet. Private equity investments in India's residential real estate market have now fallen for two consecutive quarters, reflecting the segment's diminishing investor appeal amidst a major drive to end surplus in housing stock in major cities. Data from property consultant Cushman & Wakefield shows that residential housing got ₹3,326 crore of investment in the first quarter of 2017 compared with ₹5,725 crores in the preceding October-December quarter. Due to fewer new launches and slow sales, funds are being cautious about investing in residential projects. Also, builders are not keen about seeking funds now as they want to focus on completing existing projects. Post meeting of home buyers with the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Amit Mohan Prasad, CEO Noida Authority, has called for a meeting with National President of Confederation of Real Estate Developers Association of India and several other big-ticket builders with projects in Noida. The meeting will be held on Friday, May 5th. The focus of the meeting will be to redress issues of scores of home buyers who have been agitating against developers who have failed to deliver their residential units to them. A large number of big corporates and reputed developers are entering the affordable housing segment, attracted by huge tax benefits and reforms initiated by the government. The eminent banker Deepak Parekh expressed hope that real estate prices would decline more once RBI allows banks and housing finance firms to lend to developers for land purchases and approval process for projects are further streamlined and shortened. Parekh said the government has extended the 100% tax deduction scheme for affordable housing projects approved between June 16 and March 19 by two more years till 2021. What this effectively means that any developer for affordable housing project has to pay zero tax. Indiabulls Housing Finance has announced that the rating agency CRISIL has upgraded its rating on the long-term debt instruments and bank facilities to AA+ positive from CRISIL AA+ stable, according to a regulatory filing. That's all we have in today's bulletin. See you tomorrow morning. Have a good day.